Well, it is Wellness Wednesday. As many as 900,000 people could be affected by deep vein thrombosis every year in the United States. Dr. Stephen Abramowitz, chair of vascular surgery at MedStar Health, joins us now with tips and treatment options and just generally learning more about DVT. Good morning to you. Thank you for joining us.
Good morning. Thank you for having me.
So let's start with what it is. What is deep vein thrombosis for those who are unfamiliar with it?
Yeah, you said it best. 900,000 Americans are going to suffer from some sort of venous thromboembolic event, which is a fancy way of saying a blood clot in one of the deep veins of the body. Those are the bigger veins in our legs and in our arms.
And what are the symptoms?
Well, most people are going to present with swelling, pain, heaviness in that extremity. So we're really looking for something that's isolated to one leg or one arm. And you notice a big difference in terms of the size, pain, or any of those other symptoms, swelling, heaviness, redness, or itching.
Do we know who's most at risk of developing this?
Well, there are two categories of people. 1 in 20 Americans are at risk because they have a mutation in their blood, and many of those Americans don't know about it. And the other category of people, half of patients with DVT are within 30 days of either a hospitalization or an illness, like COVID, the flu, or an injury, like a broken leg or a fractured ankle.
So, I mean, it sounds pretty scary. So I guess, how do you diagnose it and how do you treat it?
Well, the first thing is, if you have any concerns that you have a deep vein thrombosis, you should see your medical professional, your primary care doctor, or go to an urgent care facility or an emergency room. There, they're most likely going to order an ultrasound, and that ultrasound is going to show the clot in the vessel. That's a non-invasive test that uses sound waves to visualize the vein itself. If that test is positive, most patients are going to be put on a blood thinner, and some of those patients are going to ultimately require a procedure to remove the clot from that vein.
Is this something that might have to be done repeatedly?
Yeah, that's a great question. If you have a blood clot, you are more likely to have another blood clot in the next 8 to 10 years. In fact, 15% of patients who have their first clot are likely to have another clot in that time period, because without treatment or even with anticoagulation, that can lead to scarring in the vein, which changes its function and structure over time.
Now, can DVT be a sign of a more serious condition, an underlying condition?
Absolutely. And that's why it's important to get checked out. If you're in that group of people where you haven't been sick or you haven't had an injury or you're not carrying a mutation, oftentimes a DVT can be an early marker of another inflammatory process, such as cancer or an underlying autoimmune disease.
Yeah, I want to revisit the mutation really quickly. Is this something that you should be proactive about, in other words, or do you just kind of wait till perhaps you see the symptoms and then check yourself out early?
It's a great question. Wait and see. For those patients who have mutations, oftentimes they're familial. And for those patients who don't know that they have a history of this in their family, it's something that your primary care physician or another screening provider can look for, specifically in women if they've had repeated miscarriages. Mm-hmm. There are other signs in your medical history that may indicate your higher risk.
All right. Best to be informed about this, especially if you have that family history. Dr. Stephen Abramowitz, mm-hmm. chair of vascular surgery at MedStar Health. Thank you for joining us this morning. Appreciate it.
Thank you for having me.
Of course.